play on a soccer field week in and week in out. We're trying to get them to broaden their horizons and to go out on the beach, play sand soccer, play foot volley, learn new ways of training that overall help increase their game.
It's a fun game. It's a fun day, and it's exciting because there's small fields and big goals and lots of shots and lots of goals and lots of action.
And welcome back to the USU Soccer Show. Before we left, I told you about a tournament played on beaches around the country. So let's hear more about Soccer in the Sand.
Soccer in the Sand is a series of beach soccer tournaments that we started 3 years back in San Diego, which is where I'm from. And now we have a full tour.
I think this Soccer in the Sand is... it's fun. I think it's a good team building, and it helps get them in shape. You know, it's so different than playing on the grass and playing in the tournaments.
I think it's playing soccer in the sand is a lot more fun because you can play barefoot, and it's fun.
I like playing soccer in the sand because you can, like, slide tackle, and there's not very many fouls, and there's no offsides.
I like playing soccer in the sand because you can actually dive for the ball, and you can't really get hurt. If you're dribbling really fast, the ball will just stop and then you'll be really frustrated. It's just how it goes.
I think it's a great environment for the younger kids to try a diving header, to do a bicycle kick and fall down and not be hurt.
Well, we're partnering with Soccer in the Sand, and One Soccer are running, and One Sport Foundation are running a foot volley, basically a foot volley day. I don't like to call it a competition. It's for the juniors, boys and girls, and the adults league. Well, foot volley, I believe, originated in Brazil, and it's basically volleyball, but without yet the use of your hands. So it just really, really works on the touch and the technique of the player, you know, the athleticism. You have to be an athlete to play soccer, and also you have to have great touch, great first touch. First touch is everything, technique. And this game just develops that. If you can be an athlete, but if you haven't got technique in this game, you're going to get found out.
Most players, they play on a soccer field week in and week in out. We're trying to get them to broaden their horizons and to go out on the beach, play sand soccer, play foot volley, learn new ways of training that overall help increase their game.
I just think it's an opportunity for the kids to come out and enjoy the day at the beach. The siblings enjoy it, the parents like it, they can swim in between games, they can build sandcastles and whatnot, but it's just it's a ton of fun for everybody.
You know what, I think it's a great day up here on the beach, watching the girls just have fun together with their teammates. It's just a fun day.
I absolutely have a great time. We get so much soccer, and this is just another benefit. You know, having a 13-year-old play soccer is just a lot of fun.
My favorite part about the day is the whole community coming out to just celebrate the children and have them come out here and just be themselves and learn team sports and have fun.
Well, a couple years ago we did one in San Diego and just got a ton of great response, and thought that, you know, we could bring it to other beach towns where it's not being done. In Santa Barbara, you know, where we're at today is one. I mean, we're in Grand Haven, Michigan, we're in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, we're in Florida, we're in Oregon. So, I mean, we're literally all over the place where we find a lake or ocean that, you know, it's not being done. We go there and we set it up and we give the kids the opportunity to participate. And I mean, just it's a fun game. It's a fun day, and it's exciting because there's small fields and big goals and lots of shots and lots of goals and lots of action.
Meanwhile, beach soccer drew elite players and fans alike to the immaculate sands of Clearwater Beach as the USL AGM weekend extravaganza continued along the Gulf of Mexico with the addition this year of the first ever Major Beach Soccer National Championships.
The atmosphere, the environment, the directors, the support here has been tremendous. I really like the facilities. It's top class. In terms of coming here, it's something that you would want to come here with your family. The environment is great.
And there's music, you know, people smiling. There's a ton of action because it's a smaller pitch, lots of goals. And, I mean, the skill level, especially, I mean, if you see some of these men, it's unbelievable. Their technical ability and the flair of a bicycle kick or a side volley is just fun to watch. And you see people smile and clap and cheer, and it's good, you know. So that's what I like.
In 2011, USL added Major Beach Soccer to its growing list of soccer properties, bringing greater domestic attention to this sport that is hugely popular around the world.
Beach soccer is a lot bigger than, you know, people give it credit for, certainly here in the US and I think the world. I think, you know, we've seen a growth over the last year or two in terms of the amount of tournaments, and also we have now a national beach soccer federation team, and of course worldwide federations are investing into beach soccer, and obviously there's now a FIFA World Cup.
People should get involved with Major Beach Soccer because, you know, especially professional clubs, because beach soccer, it's not competing with regular soccer, it's a compliment. You know, it helps you with your fitness. It also helps you with your skills because you have to try to play in the air. So, you know, it's just a compliment not only for, you know, kids, but also adults.
The USL Major Beach Soccer National Championships brought together teams from throughout the U.S. that had qualified through a series of 8 events, all of which were put on by Major Beach Soccer and Soccer in the Sand.
I'm actually from New York, and we qualified out in California, so we sort of got a bunch of girls together out there.
Our team's located out from San Diego, California. We have girls from all over, but we mainly travel from California area.
What we're seeing here this weekend is the national championships of the qualifying teams through Soccer in the Sand, as well as through Major Beach Soccer, affiliated with USL. So, I mean, we have teams from, you know, ranging from Michigan, Ohio, North Carolina, San Diego, California. Obviously some Florida teams are represented here as well. So it's really, I mean, a North American, you know, championship.
Major Beach Soccer is on the forefront of making beach soccer a nationally recognized sport, building on the momentum that beach soccer has gained on the international stage.
I hope that beach soccer goes to a place like regular soccer, like, for example, like where they have a professional league in the United States. Some countries have it already, Italy, Brazil. So I hope that in the next few years we're able to develop a professional league.
USL's Major Beach Soccer National Championship drew a variety of clubs to Clearwater Beach. One of the participants, Peace Passers, is a nonprofit club dedicated to not only scoring goals, but also to gathering equipment to distribute to youth teams in need.
Peace Passers is actually a nonprofit organization founded 4 years ago by myself, my brother Caleb, and a couple other friends from Florida. And the mission of the organization is to collect new and used soccer equipment from donors all over the United States, and then we help to redistribute it to communities around the world.
Aside from the fast-paced beach soccer action, FIFA officials were on hand to conduct sanctioned seminars for coaches and referees, the first of its kind in the United States.
First of all, instead of 11 players, you have 5 players on the pitch. And also unique to beach soccer, the players can go in and out as much as they want. A full team is normally 10 players. The other exciting thing about beach soccer, really, is the ability to get the ball in the air. Of course, it's much harder to dribble on the sand than it is on a normal pitch. So players who understand the game get the ball in the air, and you see a lot of acrobatics, and that's unique to the game as well.
Locally, nationally, and around the world, USL is focused on growing Major Beach Soccer in the future.
The future of Major Beach Soccer moving forward, I think, is very bright. I think we're going to see not only the, you know, tournaments pop up, even more so than we see today, but I think we're going to start to see leagues pop up too, where there may be 6-week leagues in a city, you know, playing on the beach, and hopefully they'll send their championship teams to the Major Beach Soccer Championship. here at Clearwater Beach.
I think it has a great potential to catch on and become more legit. I mean, who doesn't want to travel around the U.S. or the world and kick the ball around?